Hey, hi guys, welcome to my channel Roaming Devi. Happy Easter to all of my viewers throughout the worldwide. It's a really a good day at Cape Town. It's also a very long weekend in Cape Town, so people really have a really a lovely holiday they spend in these 3-4 days, weekend holidays actually. So I didn't plan anything, but somehow last night some of my friends, they just called me that are you planning something, are you going somewhere. So it's very difficult to get even the 10 minute bookings. Luckily I just planned over the night. I got a booking, a place which is called Elands Bay, which is nearby, almost 2.5 hours from Cape Town. It's a small beachside village. So I'm going to drive there and I'll be staying there. I'll be watching some nearby places, and from there I'll go to Cedarburg. There beautiful caves are there where the Koi or San people's pictures of those days, it's there. So I need to check that. So guys, let's go and let's move on. Let's enjoy my holidays for next 4-5 days and see how it goes. And I'll show you the beautiful things whatever I see on my ways actually. Okay, keep on watching. Thank you. Hello.
Yesterday veggie burgers and the 10 piece nuggets. That's about 48.70.
Thank you. I just finished my order to MACD. So I don't know on my way where I'll stop and what I'll get, because I didn't get any time to do all my homework actually before going to this place. It was so hurry for me. So that's the reason, for my safety I'm just taking some burgers and some fries in my car, so that if I get hungry at some place then I can have my lunch inside the car. Now in the meantime, let me do some homework, that what place from here I need to drive before I reach to Elands Bay, to my guest house which I booked. So let me see what place I need to go. I just did some quick homework actually. So I just asked my friend on my way to Elands Bay what kind of things I can see. So there is a place called Barloren Vli. So it's a place where tidal mouth of a, you can say, a large river when it meets the sea. That's the place is famous for that. So that's where lot of this what you call the birds used to hang around. Some thousands of birds will be there. So I'll have a good chance to see those beautiful birds at that place. And it is a significantly, it's a coastal lake. So I don't have much knowledge on that, but let me go and watch what is there. You can see it's an estuary actually. So I'm now going to switch on my GPS in my cell phone, where I need to put the place Barloren Vli. So sorry my South African friends, if I'm not pronouncing this place correctly, just forgive me. My accent is Indian, so I might not have the way how you guys pronounce actually. So you can see it's 2 hours and 3 minutes, 198 kilometers. So I need to drive from here. There are multiple routes are there, and obviously in Easter time it's always a big rush on the road. So I usually travel by this route, R27, but this time I'll drive in this way. It's a new route for me. I'll explore this new route. Hope I'll see a beautiful scenic drive on this route also. Finally, my MACD order is all ready, so I need to drive and I need to go to the place. One thing is there, whenever I travel, I make sure when I'm going out of Cape Town for a long drive, I make sure my passports, my mobile charger, have some cash in my hand. Although cards are there and cards is going to work everywhere, but still I carry some cash. And I also make sure that my friends knows where I'm traveling actually. I give them the GPS locations also for my safety. So, but it is always pleasant to have all those things in your intact, so that you can travel safe and drive safe also in these Easter holidays. People drive really crazy in Cape Town, I mean in South Africa. So you need to be very careful while driving. You have to follow the driving rules, maintain your speed, don't use alcohol while driving. Police will be checking, there will be speed cameras everywhere. So enjoy your drive and also enjoy your scenic beauties and stay safe. Okay, so let me start my driving to Allen's Bay, 2.5 hours. I just drove from Cape Town to the place called Wallonian Blee, where this is the biggest estuaries in the Western Cape, where estuaries means where the wetland emitting to the sea. I heard that there are a lot of pelicans and thousands of other species of birds which I can see in that meeting point. But unfortunately, I asked the local and the wetland is already dried up and there is no more rains actually. That's where these pelicans and other flamingo birds, they are not anymore coming here. So I'm just going near to that wetland bed. I can see far from here that's really wet, very less water is there, and it is the water where it goes and mix up with the sea, and that's where all these birds come and get their fish and all to eat, and people also, the bird lovers, they also come and visit and take a lot of pictures. But unfortunately the situation has changed. Although it is known as a lost wetland, but I can see it is really lost. It's very less water. Let me go and walk around and see, show the bed of that wetland actually. You can see this is the wetland where it starts from many kilometers far from here on the way I saw, and it's completely empty, and you can see there is no water here, only one patch of water I can see here. There might be some other patch, and you can hear the sea sound. It just go by, it just flow this way and then it turns somewhere and meets the sea actually. I don't see any bird here. See this red colored water, it's completely dry. You can see it's empty here, no water. Although I'm hearing a lot of beautiful bird sound here. So sorry guys, bad luck for me. I don't find any pelicans or any flamingo birds or any such kind of beautiful birds because there is no water here. It's completely dry. So, but you can see beautiful the view here. It's really amazing. You can see the fogs from sea is coming on this wet bed actually. That mountain is called Bavian Mountain actually, where my guest house is just below the mountain. It's just in front of the sea. And if I go far from this mountain, little bit, almost 3-4 kilometers, then I can find a cave which is called Islands Bay Cave, where these sand paintings are there. I need to drive there to show you that sand paintings is my next video. So this is a very long estuary stretching from the village of Islands Bay to Rattling Bays actually. So it's almost 25 kilometers of Lambert's Bay. And what I understand from various websites that these birds really they come here, and they, because of this muddy wetland, so they get their food and the fishes what they like, and they stay here, and it's kind of an habitat for them to stay and have their life here. So it's unfortunate that I could not see all those birds. So I need to now drive to Islands Bay Cave, where sand paintings are there. That's the first sand painting I'm going to see, and how beautiful. Let me go through that. It's almost 4-5 kilometers from here. I need to drive. Okay, so let me move back.